Hey, this is Sundar from C4E Tech, and in today's video, let's unbox the new Moto E4 Plus from Lenovo. We have the box here. Some basic specs can be found to the back. Opening up the box, we have the phone itself. Let's keep it aside for the moment. This reminds me of the Moto C Plus that I unboxed a few weeks back. Everything's just piled up in there. We have the earphones, a 10 watts 2 amps travel adapter that supports rapid charging, a micro USB cable, some reading material, and the SAR values. Let's peel this off. To the front, we have a single LED flash, the earpiece, sensors, a 5 megapixel selfie camera, and below that a 5.5 and 720p display covered by 2.5D Gorilla Glass 3, and a fingerprint scanner. To the back, we have the secondary noise cancelling microphone, a 13 megapixel camera, a single LED flash, and the Moto branding. To the bottom, we have the primary microphone, the micro USB port, and a loudspeaker. The power button and the volume rockers can be found to the right. There's a 3.5mm headphone jack up top, and there's nothing to the left. The SIM slots and the micro SD card slot can be found inside. Yeah, the back is removable. Underneath the hood, this phone is powered by the MediaTek MT6737 quad-core processor, clocked at 1.3 GHz. Coupled with the Mali T720 GPU, 3 GB of RAM and 32 GB of onboard storage. Note that the storage can be expanded by using a microSD card of up to 128 GB. All this is powered by a humongous 5000mAh battery. The Moto E4 Plus runs on the latest Android 7.1.1 Nougat, and since it's stock Android, the user experience is smoother than I thought it would be, given the poor MediaTek chip. There is support for Dolby Atmos, which enhances the media experience, be it listening to music or recording using the dual microphones. And thanks to the MediaTek chip, Moto actions like flip, shake, and twist don't work here. They are limited to actions like one-button navigation. Now that's something I really like, allows for some extra screen real estate. We also do have the Moto display feature. Neat. The phone feels good in the hand. At 198 grams, I feel it's quite bulky, but that's expected given the large battery inside. The fingerprint sensor here is an active scanner. Initial impressions, it recognizes fingerprints quite fast, but it takes a while to get to the home screen. That said, it doesn't seem to have any issues with accuracy. Works every single time. The camera interface is quite familiar. Shutter response is not that great, there's quite a bit of lag. Here are a few pictures we quickly shot around the office. I didn't have a pleasant experience with tap to focus either. What do you think about the camera performance? Here's a poll, let us know. Anyway, the Moto E4 Plus is now available on Flipkart for 10,000 rupees, and you'd be surprised to know over 100,000 units have already been sold. What do you think about this phone? Love it? Or hate Moto's decision to go with a mediocre chip again? Let me know in the comments below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to C4E Tech for more like this. Do this to make sure you get notified each time a video goes live on the channel. Thanks a lot for watching. This is Sundar from C4E Tech, leaving for the moment. Have a great day.